Hello everyone and welcome to my channel English for Beginners Academy. Assalamu alaikum, marhaba bikum, akum Naja, English for Beginners Academy. Today's video is going to be about opening and closing a letter. الأغلبية كي يعطيكم مثلا في الامتحانات in the writing section to write an essay and sometimes a letter. Most of the time هذاك هو اللي كيكون في الامتحانات وكيكون تنقيط عليهم شوية كبير ولذلك الا كنتو ضبطتوهم ان شاء الله كتكونوا ضمنتو واحد النسبه ديال النقاط اللي غادي تعاونكم زيدوا عليها هذاك الشيء ديال الجرامر والكومبريهنشن وي شود بي جود فور يور تيست ولا فور يور اكزام. هذا الا كنتو طلبه وكتشوفوا هذا الفيديو لانكم بغيتوا تبريباريو شي امتحان ولا بالنسبه للرايتينغ ليتر it doesn't matter like in daily life دابا ولينا اغلبيه كلشي كيكتب letters and especially in the form of emails حيت ما بقاش دابا تقريبا the traditional way to write a letter through the post office ولكن it's still there but like you can use this pattern also in writing emails okay so تبعوا معنا حتى الاخر الحلقه ديال اليوم غادي تكون only about the opening and the closing okay ما غنديروش البادي غنديرو في شي حلقه اخرى ولكن هادو غادي نشارك معكم تقريبا the do's and the don'ts اللي يمكن ديروهم وباش تكتبوا like kind of a perfect letter. So تبعوا الفيديو حتى الاخر وإلا كان عجبكم المحتوى ما تنساوش وما تبخلوش like it, share it with your friends. Okay, so قبل ما نبداو ونمشيو لهذوك الopening and closing phrases اللي كنديرو we need to know the type of letters. بغيت نشارك معكم الأنواع ديال letters. Okay? حيتاش كاينين ثلاثة الأنواع في الإنجليزية. Now, formal letter. عندنا semi-formal ولا semi-formal letter وعندنا informal letter غنعطيكم التعريف والأمثلة من بعد لهادو في الفيديو okay وعندنا زدت لكم هاد section over here about the purpose of the letter purpose ولا الهدف ديال الرسالة right علاش زدت لكم تما لأن الهدف ديال الرسالة هو اللي كيحدد لينا التايب اللي غادي نختارو alright so مثلا ملي كيعطيكم سؤال في الامتحان write a letter كيعطيكم situation كيقولك write a letter to do this and that okay so it depends على situation it depends على receiver of the letter so كتلقى الجواب من تما ولا few hints اللي كتلقى في السؤال حد في حد ذاته اللي كيحدد لك دير formal ولا semi-formal ولا informal letters okay so هنايا عطيتكم غير بعض الأمثلة واللي هي غالبا كتكون متداولة okay ممكن يكونوا other purposes ولكن I got them هنايا حيتاش هما الأغلبية اللي متداولة okay so sometimes you are writing a letter to request information مثلا كيعطيكم write a letter باش تسول information about like the prices ديال hotel rooms ولا مثلا you wanna rent a car you call the agency and to ask about the prices and so on sometimes the purpose is to complain about something that happened to you and to seek some solution or to find out like some solution how to solve that problem okay last thing I included here is like the purpose of your letter can be like an invitation like you're writing a letter to invite someone to attend like a meeting or like to attend like a wedding or like a birthday party it depends okay so situations they differ and they will determine the type of letter that you're writing. Some, right? All right, right now, let's delve into the opening and closing of a letter that will help you, okay? دابا غنشوفو together the first type اللي هو formal letters, okay? خديت هنا واحد جوج سميات if you can see them. Sam Johnson or Sarah Santos. These are just random names because we're gonna be using them as examples okay throughout this course في الفورمال ليتر باش كنعرفوها ولا tips like to help you know if you're gonna be writing like a formal letter or not. If a formal letter, someone you don't know in person can كتبوا a letter شي واحد اللي ما كنعرفوش مثلا ما كنعرفوش in person ما عمرناش شناه we don't know that person at all and we're not sure if he is a man or she is a woman so like we're like writing a letter to a company you don't know if the manager is a woman or a man you have no idea okay that requires like you to write like a formal letter okay the other hint I'm giving you here there is no name given okay مثلا they will ask you write to this hotel manager but they don't give you مثلا Sam or Johnson or Sarah Santos they don't give you the name of the person they just tell you write a letter to this company that's a hint that you can get from the question that you need ولا you must write formal letter okay well I give you here examples like when you're writing to a hotel or like insurance or a bank these are examples where you don't know the person you just need to know the company and you are required to write a letter so what kind of letter we're gonna pick we're gonna go for the formal letter in this example okay so in this case we already know we're gonna write the formal letter right we don't know the names okay so basically we can't use them okay so please don't write the name so this is how you're gonna start this type of letter formal letter you're gonna write dear sir because you don't know the name but you at least know that it's a man على الاقل كتعرف انها كتادريسي لواحد راجل ماشي مراه so you write dear sir but you don't know their name okay if you don't know the exact name but you know at least she is a woman okay هنا مرا ولكن ما عارفش السميه ديالها you're gonna write there madam okay so there sir there madam الكيس الحاله الثالثه هو when you don't know the gender ديال هذاك receiver ما عارفوش واش مرا ولا راجل you don't know if it's a man or woman You don't know, you just wanna write a letter. In this case, you need to write Dear Sir or Madam. One phrase. Okay? So, Dear Sir, if you don't know the name, but you know at least it's a man. Dear Madam, if you know that she's a woman, but you don't know the name. Dear Sir or Madam, if you don't know the gender of the person. For the closing, the most formal closing in this case, we use yours faithfully. Yours faithfully. بجوجهم. ماشي غير yours ولا غير faithfully. Yours faithfully. Make sure to put a double L for the faithfully. Alright, we're done with the formal letter. ودابا غنشوفو together the semi-formal letter, okay? So, ملي كنكتبوها, you are writing to someone you know. But you're not friends with, okay? هذا situation اللي كتكونوا كنكتبوا لشي واحد اللي كنعرفوه ماشي ما كنعرفوش بحال المثال الاولاني اللي درنا كتعرفوه ولكن ماشي اصدقاء بزاف باش غادي نزعموا عليهم اوكي سو you choose the semi formal letter okay ولا when you know the name of the person قبيله شنا you don't know the name of the person that's why we did it formal هذه case you know the name of the person مثلا غنشوفو Sam Johnson or Sarah Santos we know the name of that person but we're not friends كنعرفوهم ولكن ماشي اصدقاء كنعرفو سميتهم okay so كنختارو هاد style so depending had few things كيخليوك تعرف شنو النوع ديال letter اللي غادي تخدم اللي غادي دير في الامتحان وهناك غادي تحصد شويه ديال النقاط اللي غادي يساعدوك okay So, مثلا عطيتكم امثلة هنايا باش تعرفوا مثلا example ديال school my kids school teacher مثلا I know their name and I know them I saw them a couple of times but we're not friends in this case you go or like when you write a letter or like you write an email it will be advisable like to use the semi formal letter. Or مثلا you're living in like a complex or anything, like you need to write like to an office manager because you know them but you're not friends. This is what you need to use the semi formal letter. So now that you know the situation, let's see how we can do the opening and the closing. Okay, in this case, we already said that you know the name. So Sam Johnson and Sarah, in this case, you need to write it this way. Okay, we write, dear Mr. Johnson. Okay, why? Because we know that he is a man. So we need to include this one, Mr. Johnson. And if you notice, I didn't put Sam Johnson. I didn't put Mr. Sam Johnson. So only include the last name and don't include the first name. All right? Got that? Next thing, we write Mr. regardless if the person is married or single. It's easy for men, right? You're gonna see, like for women, it's something different. But for men, it depends. You write Mr., it doesn't matter. But the only thing you need to remember, don't include the full name. Don't put the first name. You need to include only the last name. And you need to write Mr. in front of it. And don't forget to put everything capital letter, of course. That's something you should know by now. Okay? Now, for women, okay, writing similar formal letter, but the addressee is like a woman, Sarah Santos in this case. We have three situations in this case. So the first one, when you if you know for sure that the person is single, you put dear Miss Santos. Miss Santos, you know they are single, they are not married. And you write dear Mrs. Santos if you know that they are married or widow. And the last one I put here a little asterisk over here because this one is a little bit different. Like this one, it's pronounced like Miss, even if there's an S, but you can pronounce it as a Miss. And that's like when you don't know if the person is single or if the person is married. And usually sometimes they use this one, like for example to address like a teacher. Sometimes when I substitute in some school, they say I'm Miss Najat. So I hope that you get the difference between all these three. So it's not much about like when you know the person and if it's a male, but when it's a female, you need to pay attention to these small details. Now to the closing. So for the closing, for this type of letter, this is like kind of traditional way to close it. Yours sincerely, okay? And you don't forget about like how you write. That these are two words, but you need to include both of them as well. All right? Now to the next type. ودابا معنا آخر نوع من letters اللي هو informal letters. This is quite an easy, كتاخد أريحية في الكتابة ديالو. وهذا غادي نشوفو الopening ديالو والclosing. علاش كناخدو في الأريحية ديالنا؟ لأنهم simply because we're addressing like a friend, we're writing a letter to a friend of ours. So somebody you don't need to be too formal or like choose like the formal style to write a letter in this one. So for the informal letter, you know the person and you are friends. كما قلنا أنهم أصدقاء ماشي مشكل أنك كتاخذ أريحية في الكتابة ديال الكلام, ولكن مع ذلك يبقى واحد ستايل ديال الكتابة ديال opening والclosing مهم جدا. مثلا these are like example ديال friends ديالك relative والأصدقاء ولا الأقارب, هادو كما كان نديروش فيهم formal letter. مثلا opening كيكون بهذا الشكل هذا. Remember عندنا Sarah Santos and Sam Johnson. In this case we said we write dear Sam. Okay, كنكتبو غير dear Sam, ما كنديروش last name. So no last name included. Ulla, there, Sarah, we don't include the last name. It doesn't matter, la sir or la ma'am, so because it's an informal letter. For the closing, the best common ones that we use frequently are best wishes or la best regards. كانت هذه هي نهاية ديال الحلقة ديال اليوم, opening and closing a letter. نتمنى انكم تكونوا استفدتوا منها شي شوية, وحاولنا تلقطوا واحد العبارات اللي هما شائعة ليك في writing a letter. We talked about formal, semi-formal and informal letters, وهضر لكم على situation اللي كتخليكم ولا الهينتس ولا حواجي كيخليكم باش تعرفوا واش formal ولا type اللي غادي تختاروا. وإلا كنتو ديجا عرفتوا من السؤال شنو من type, كتوليو كتختاروا هذوك العبارات اللي مناسبة على كل تايب على حدة. إذا عجبكم الفيديو ممكن تشاركوه مع أصدقاء ديالكم باش تعمل فائدة وتساعدوني وتشجعوني حتى نتوما. ولا كان عندكم أي سؤال ولا شي حاجة كتبوه في الكومنت بالله. إذا كنتو بغيتو ندير لكم أنواع أخرين ولا نديرو أمثلة مثلا على التايب ديالهم, let me know في الكومنت بالله. شكرا بزاف, خليكم الراحة, وإلى فيديو آخر إن شاء الله. Take care.